Welcome everybody to Whiteface Mountain for the last day of competition at these 2023 Lake Placid FISU World University Games. This is the men's slalom event. You can see the mascot there, Adirondack Mac. Conditions are pretty good. It's got a lot colder, and we've had a little bit of new snow that's come down overnight. So it's 64 gates, 63 of them turning gates, so there's one banana gate. And we have a large field of 90 skiers. Watch out for number 5, Jeremy Lagier of France, and also Jacob Dilling. We've got to number 14, Xavier Strand, a two-time Olympian. We've got a lot of skiers here that could contend, and they'll be looking to make that top 30 cut. So Ulysses Crétin, 20 years old, from Lemonwier in the Three Valleys region of France, is off and running. Number 1, great opportunity. The top 15 draw their bibs. See the course already starting to chatter slightly. The forerunners will have been down. Flat opening section to this course. And then it drops away onto the pitch. There's a verticale there. Oh, and just couldn't control the speed out of the verticale.
Come on, Jacob, go, 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 go!
Watch out for Jacob Dilling now. Quick in the slalom section of the combined. Dilling from University of Colorado in Boulder. Quite a wide-ish stance, particularly on the offset gates. Narrows it as he goes through the verticale, obviously. Now this is where number 1 went down, and that's much better. Making the turn above the gate, pressure on the outside ski, getting that early platform. We're onto the steep now. This is where the course really goes across the hill. And Jacob Dilling is going to set a good time. Riding the inside ski there over the second last gate, and 52.87. That's a great time for the American. This is the one to watch now, Jeremy Lagier. Lots of upper body, lower body separation from the French skier. And you could compare him to Clément Noël. He's quite tall and uses that his height to get the feet right out from underneath him. Jacob Dillon's split time, and Lagier is 3/10 up. Now he should enjoy this big offset here. As long as he can stay nice and from behind on the turns, this is good skiing from the Frenchman. This could well be the lead. It's going to be close. That was a little bit late in the line. Dillon is going to be challenged. Oh, 1400s off, so that's going to set things up really nicely for a very good second run. It's Gianluca Boom from Switzerland. Skis out of Pontresina, just near Samaritz, from the Montana State University. Wearing his university colors. 0.32 down. Now, this is the, these are the crucial turns. Coming onto the steep pitch. It's not bad, but it's just dropping into the rut ever so slightly. Timing not quite there. Good now. And seventh place. So course conditions are starting to deteriorate. Gustav Dahlman of Sweden in third. And there's quite a gap. He is just over a second back. So number 12 on course. It's Shin Jong-woo from Korea, from Jongsai University. Oh, he's a real gate shinner, isn't he? Getting his skis really close to the base of the gates. Now onto the steep section, got to come a little bit more from behind. Oh, these are nice turns. Just lost pressure on the outside ski on that right-footed turn just before the hairpin. So a slight mistake on the steepest part of the course, but goes back to shinning again. How did he not straddle that second last gate? Great time from Shin. Shin by name and Shin by nature. Well, Loic Schabel from Switzerland. Seventh in the Super G, and he's from Westminster College in Utah. We're representing Westminster College. Narrow stance on the course, on the top part of the course. He's matched the Americans' intermediate time, but this is where Dilling was so good. And as the course starts to chop and rut, once you get these big offsets, you've got to make sure that your ski is in that rut. Otherwise, you drop down, you can't cut the turn off. You've got to ski slightly around a route, a longer distance, and that's when you lose the speed. But 0.85 down in fourth place, that is good from start number 13. Now, Jan Zabistran, the face of alpine skiing at these FISU World University Games. Here in Whiteface Mountain, Lake Placid almost went down on the inside ski there after that big build-up. Winner of the Super G, winner of the GS. So this slalom skiing hasn't been... Oh, we just got the stick between the skis there. Had to hike that back out. What's the intermediate time? Oh, it's quick. It is quick with those mistakes. He's 0.62 up. Well, I spoke to his coaches this morning and they said that slalom hasn't been going that well this season. Zabistran, two-time Olympian, raced in Pyeongchang and in Beijing. And this is going to be tight. Will it be the lead? Not quite. Zabistran, a good ski from a later start number. The top 15 are drawn, and he's right in touch for a second-run charge. So we have Dilling still in the lead, Lagier, and then that... third place now going to Zabistran, just ahead of Shin. Loic Schabel has moved into fifth, and Gustav Dahlmann, who was in third, immediately knocked down into sixth place. So we've had three quick skiers in a row. We're on to bib 15, Koyama Takeyuki. And Takeyuki also quick on the top flats. Takeyuki on to the pitch, just a little bit back seat. Wait, the hips are back. Oh, seat of the pants stuff. And you can see how far he's sitting back when you get that shot from the side. It's risky. Is it quick? Well, fifth place. Good time for the skier from Japan. So Maximilian Hausmann from Germany on course now. Wearing bib 27. Hausmann, 21 years old, from the ski club of Reutlingen. Long legs that he can get out from underneath his body and get the center of mass going straight down the hill, and it's a good split time from the German. Hausmann goes to Plymouth State University. And this is a good run for the German from a higher start number, tucking across the line. Good time. That's a great time for the start number with the course breaking up. And we can have a look at our leaderboard. Jacob Dilling, Jeremy Lagier in second place there. Jan Sabistrand from a start number of 14 did really well to be just 4/10 off, as well as Shin Jong-Woong of Korea. And anyone in this top 10 could challenge for the medals. Everyone will get a second run, but if you want to challenge for the medals, you need to be in that top 30. So run two, you can see that the track has been skied in by the forerunners already. Number 10 on course, it's Gustav Rosberg Vollå from Utah State, the Norwegian, skiing for Utah State University. And 26 hundredths has a lead. Oh, he was so close to the gate, the base of the gate there. He's boot topping the gates. Can't do that down the steep here because there's a little rut that has developed. And this is good skiing. This could take the lead away from Paget. So tight on the gates. Cutting the line to perfection. Is it going to be green? Yes, it is. I thought it was. Down that finish pitch. That was great skiing from Gustav Rosberg Vollå. So Gianluca Boom of Switzerland. From the ski resort of Pontresina, just near Samaritz, skis for the Montana State University. And wearing the catsuit of Montana State. Just getting the timing off ever so slightly there. You can see that the ruts are starting to develop. 1600s into the green. Nice turns through this section. Really good. Good skiing from the Finn. Sorry, from the Swiss. Gianluca Boom, will he take the lead away? It's going to be tight. It's very tight. 1/100th of a second. Oh. Federico Toscano of Switzerland, 21/100th of a second. His advantage over the current leader, Gustav Rosberg Vollå of Norway. Federico Toscano from San Bernardino Ski Club and goes to the IUBH Hochschule in Switzerland. So Toscano maintains his advantage, 2200s up. It's not much to play with when you consider that the Norwegian was so good down on this finish pitch. Oh, that was a mistake. That was a mistake. Oh, pitched forward, just managing to make it through the hairpin towards the line and misses it by 500s. Well, currently the top three are separated by just 500s of a second, as Tormis Lane of Estonia pushes out with a 1/4 of a second lead. The Estonian has raced in 2 Olympic Games, just 22 years old. So he must have been pretty young when he went to the first one. Goes to MCI Management College in Innsbruck. 500ths of a second, still to the good. Just looks to be a little bit late on the line and dropping into these ruts. And there's a lot of pressure after the gate. Early pressure on the turn is good, so you can release the turning ski. This late pressure. Well, it's going to be... Oh, not quite enough. Fourth place. Cheer of come on, Louis. Louis Gustav Fosa of Norway. Part of the University of Colorado at Boulder. Nice rhythm on the top of the course. Finding the top of the rut. Get the ski into it. Oh, there were some mistakes there. I couldn't really see what the skis were doing, but it did look like there was a couple of heavier edge sets, and you can see the snow flying up. He's got 0.18 of an advantage going on to the finish pitch, but there was another correction. Good recovery. Didn't lose too much time, but he definitely lost a tenth or two. So needs to attack the final turns. Oh, and he's going for it. Really going for it down these last 10 to 15 turns. It's going to be fourth place. Just a couple of tenths lost on the final pitch. And it is so tight at the top. And you feel that if anyone beats one of them, they'll beat all of them, with just 500 separating them. Loic Schabel of Switzerland. Skiing for the Westminster College in Utah. Seventh in the Super G. Nice calm upper body. Oh, but the forward arm balance really risked there. 0.54 now. This could be a good enough lead going on to the finish pitch to take the lead away. Loic Schabel of Switzerland. Oh, a couple of turns where he was just jetted out with the acceleration again. Full risk from Schabel. But seemed to lose a little bit of speed at the end, but he's still done enough to take the lead away. And Schabel now into the leader's chair.
We have got to see that on
Well, took all the risks. Koyama Takeuchi from Japan. Studies at the Nihon University. Fifth fastest after the first run. Current leader, Loic Schabel. Oh, very close in on the gates. This is lovely skiing from the Japanese. Koyama, 1400. Oh, inside ski mistake. Got away with it. Stood on the inside ski and again. Jetted into the turn. Well, a couple of mistakes will have cost a few tenths. And again, getting jetted and late on the line. I'm not sure if this is good enough for the lead with those mistakes. And 10th place only for Koyama of Japan. Cannot afford these mistakes where you're jetted out of the turn. So Jan Zabistrand, already the winner of two gold medals. Nothing to lose for the Czech skier. And he took the bronze in the combined. Well, he could get a whole hat-trick of medals. Lovely skiing. Just so smooth. No mistakes so far from Zabichan. And he's built on his lead. 1.24 now up. If Zabistrand can be clean on the steep part of the course, he's going to really throw the gauntlet down to the final two skiers that have got a chance of winning this competition. This is lovely skiing from Jan Zabistrand. Zamistran from the Czech Republic is producing a masterclass in slalom and takes the lead by just over 1 second. And that could well be the gold medal winning run. So two left, who could challenge? The first of them, Jeremy Lagier of France, 25 years old, skiing for the Westminster College in Utah. A slender lead over Zabistrat. Will he maintain that lead? Lagier is going for it. It's full attack from the Frenchman. But yes, it is. It's maintained the lead of 44 hundredths of a second, but there was a mistake. There was a mistake. It cost maybe a tenth. On to the steepest part of the course. Again, another mistake going around the outside, jetted out of the rut. And a couple of little more mistakes, so this will be very, very tight. Zabistrat leads in the finish with 51.38, and it's just outside by 5 hundredths of a second. Well, you've got to have the luck, and when it comes down into the hundreds, the honeys, as they say, they've got to be on your side. Jacob Dilling now, 4 tenths of a lead over Zabistrat from the first run. His parents, both Kim and Rick, ski instructors in Vail, very much part of the Vail Ski Club, now going to university in Colorado, the University of Colorado in Boulder. Well, this is good from the top. Maybe he had 4 tenths lead. What's it going to be at the intermediate time? No, it's gone into the red, the wrong side of the clock. 16 hundredths of a second to find to take the gold medal. Jacob Dilling, can he hang in there? Stay in touch, there's a... It's really tight at the top, just 500s between Zabistrat and Lagier. Dilling, is he gonna get the gold? Will it be bronze? It's bronze by 900ths of a second. You could not get much closer than that. Jan Zabistrat has a certain amount of good fortune on his side. And I think he would be the first to admit that, to win a race by 500ths of a second. In third place, Jacob Dilling, just 900ths back. Well, that's your medals. I don't think I've seen a men's slalom as tight in a long, long while. The top three separated by just 900ths of a second.